This chapter, The Black Beret, the story of Field Marshal Bernard Montgomery. He was England's greatest general. Rows of medals attested to his victories. Yet in the beginning, it was freely predicted that he would fail as a soldier. Born in 1887, Bernard Montgomery started life in a strange setting for a future military hero. Religion was the greatest single influence in those early days. Montgomery's father was a bishop of the Church of England. He hoped his son would follow his example and become a churchman. But young Monty was rebellious, unwilling to follow anyone. One day, the bishop announced his son was entering the army. At Sandhurst Military School, young Monty was unpopular, too headstrong and sharp-tongued. Instructors said he'd fail in the regular service, and they were right for many years. When the First World War began, Montgomery was only a lieutenant. On the Western Front, he was wounded and received a medal, but he was too opinionated to suit his superiors. Years passed. By the time of the Second World War, Monty was a general, but still unpopular because he believed in mechanized armies. The disaster of 1940 proved him right. The British retreated, utterly beaten, smashed by the German blitzkrieg. Their one chance of survival was evacuation at Dunkirk. Monty's division survived the retreat almost intact because he had trained it in blitzkrieg tactics. Now, away to England and safety. Coming ashore, Monty's men could thank their stubborn commander for their lives. But there was no time for rejoicing. A German invasion of England was expected at any moment. Montgomery's home was destroyed in a German air raid. His wife was dead, his young son orphaned. Suffering hardened Monty's resolve. Someday he would make Germany burn as England was burning now. Meanwhile, Winston Churchill had become Prime Minister and moved into the residence at number 10 Downing Street. He promoted Montgomery to command of the British 8th Army in Africa. Monty flew to Egypt. The story of the Black Beret was about to begin in the sands of El Alamein. A soldier had lent Monty the beret. He kept it for luck and started preparations for an offensive against the Germans. His battle-weary troops complained. The enemy commander, Erwin Rommel, was a master of desert warfare. Did Montgomery, who knew nothing about the desert, seriously think he could defeat the desert fox? With supreme determination, Monty issued his battle order. We shall win here or die. As the tanks rolled out to take position for the battle, Monty's will to win was